saying we are going to call mind blur canine. You can see I have marked the root crown length, root length, liver surface, distal surface, lingual surface and the basal surface. So coming to the labial surface, I have drawn lines representing the shape of the crown, which is converging towards the cervical line, and medial, small medial slope and length of distal slope. Compared to the maxillary canine, mandibular canine will be lesser in dimensions. So we are going to start carving by reducing the wax on the distal and medial surface first up to the drawn line like this. I am creating a notch here followed by the removal of wax. After removal on the distal surface, we are going to remove on the mesial surface. Okay, so I am creating a notch here followed by the removal of wax. Can you see? I have reduced wax on both mesial and distal surfaces. So far, we remove all the wax on the incisal edge to shape the incisal margin of the canine like this. Can see the mesial marginal ridge is always lesser than the distal marginal ridge. Okay, like this. So then I am going to reduce wax up to the midline drawn here like this. I'm going to reduce the wax near the cervical line. And I'm drawing a line from the cervical line to the tip of the crown. And I'm going to reduce this wax like this. I am creating slopes on the labial surface so that I am creating the ridge here. Can you see? And then I am rounding it up the near the cervical line, cervical 1/3 of the crown. I think you can notice the ridge here. Then coming to the lingual surface, we are going to wax, remove the wax. Like this. So always the canine's cingulum is more prominent compared to central incisor and lateral incisor. So we are keeping it prominent. So I am going to shape the cingulum part of the mandibular canine I'm rounding it. I'm maintaining the bulk of the cervical region, and I'm going to draw a line here in the middle. So then I will be starting to slope on the mesial and distal curves on the lingual side of the crown. To form a lingual ridge also. Then we are going to reduce wax around the crown like this, so that I can increase the length of the crown a little. Can you see now? So I'm going to draw lingual depressions here on either side of the lingual ridge. I'm going to round the single media a little bit. Carving of the mandible of canine, right canine. Crown is completed. Then we'll start for polishing. Can you see now? Crown, distal side, lingual side, and middle side. And I'm starting to carve the root. I'm creating notches on all the sides like this. Then I'm going to reduce the wax on the surface around the all around the root. It's a gross reduction. I'm reducing it fast. For the canines, even the roots are more bulkier compared to central and lateral incisors, so that we are maintaining the bulkiness of the root. We are not reducing more wax. Then I am going to draw cervical line. I'm making the cervical end prominent by reducing the bags all around the cervical region. Like this. And I start polishing the root surface, holding on the crown so that I will not break up from the base. And block in labial, distal, lingual, and mesial surfaces. You can see it is more tapering compared to maxillary sept. Maxillary canine. Hope you like this carving video. If you like, please click on like button and share with friends. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.